about touching the floor. Whoa! Okay, and then when I count to three, we're gonna jump up all together as high as you can. You guys ready? One, two, three.
With all my heart, with all my soul, with all my mind, with all my strength, with all my heart, with all my soul, with all my mind, with all my strength. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. La 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 la
la la la la. What a wonderful day it is. Let's celebrate our moms. I hope you've already given yours a great big hug and a kiss on the cheek and said, thank you for being my mom. So what did you do for your mom for Mother's Day? Some of you may have made muffins, I hope. If you picked up a kit yesterday, you got some muffins for mom. And if you haven't done it already, maybe you'll get the opportunity to do it today. Get ready to start some worship. Here we go.
I've seen
Able to visit us at the depot, we gave you a packet. It's a coloring book. Now, if you've already colored it, get it. It's a lot of fun to continue to do. But if you didn't color it, get it now, and we'll color it as we learn along with the video. The video tells us a lot about the different moms in the Bible, and I think you're going to really like this. So try to keep up, have fun, and here we go.
Happy Mother's Day! Did you know Mother's Day cards are the third most popular greeting cards in America? I'm Nathan with Kids Enjoying Jesus, and I want to show you a Mother's Day Bible lesson for kids that's also a craft and a Mother's Day card all packed into one. This Mother's Day Bible lesson for kids shows how God used mothers as part of His plan to provide a savior. First, you color the pictures, then you fold it into a Mother's Day card that you use to teach the Bible lesson. After the lesson, you can have the kids color their own picture and make their own card to share with someone who takes care of them. You can get your own copy of this lesson and a Bible game to go with it at kidsenjoyingjesus.com. Every year on Mother's Day, millions of people give cards that say things like, I love you, or Happy Mother's Day to their moms or someone else who takes care of them, like their grandma or a foster mom. It's a way to say thank you to the people who take care of us. Imagine you are making a thank you card for your mother or someone else who takes care of you. What kind of things could you write inside of it? I wrote a poem inside of my card. Can you read it with me? It says, thank you for the things you do to care for me and help me too. Thank you for the things you say to teach and guide me every day. Thank you for the things you give to meet my needs so I can live. Thanks so much for all you do. I'm thankful that God gave me you. It's good to thank the ones who care for you. Did you know nobody else cares for you as much as God does? He cares for you even more than a mother or father ever can. The Bible says, for my mother and my father have forsaken me, but the Lord will take me in. Even if everyone else on earth quit loving you, God won't stop. He is perfect and He loves you with a perfect love. One way He shows His love is that He made mothers and other people to help take care of you. He also used mothers to show His love for people all around the world in an extra special, extra important way. I have a picture here of the very first mother ever. Do you know what her name was? God made Adam and Eve, the very first people, thousands of years ago. He wanted them to be happy with Him forever. Does Eve look really happy? No, Eve is not happy because she and Adam ruined the perfect world by breaking God's rules. Now all people are born wanting to sin by breaking God's rules. Sin causes terrible problems and keeps people far away from God. The Bible says, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." But after Adam and Eve sinned, God promised that Eve would become a mother, and one of her descendants, which means someone born in her family after her, like a son, grandson, or great-great-great-grandson, one of them would be a mighty savior, someone who would save people from sin. Many years passed, and Eve had billions of descendants. In fact, you and me are one of her descendants. Take a deep breath and say what I say. Ready? Eve is our great 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 grandmother. All the people in the world came from Eve's family. Which one would be the savior? Many years later, God made a promise about another mother. He chose a man named Abraham and said his wife Sarah would have a son and start a family that would eventually become huge. But this promise seemed crazy because Abraham and Sarah were way too old to have kids. The Bible says, "Now Abraham and Sarah were old, advanced in years. The way of women had ceased to be with Sarah. So Sarah laughed to herself, saying, 'After I am worn out and my Lord is old, shall I have pleasure?' The Lord said to Abraham, 'Why did Sarah laugh and say, "Shall I indeed bear a child now that I am old? Is anything too hard for the Lord? At the appointed time, I will return to you about this time next year, and Sarah shall have a son.'" Sarah laughed about God's promise because she was way too old to have a baby. But God promised she would become a mother, and many great kings would come from her descendants, including the mighty Savior, the greatest king of all, who would save people from sin. It happened just like God said. Abraham and Sarah did have a baby boy and eventually had millions of descendants, and many of them became powerful kings. But which one would be the Savior? Well, God chose one of Abraham and Sarah's great, 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 great granddaughters named Mary to be the mother of the Savior. He sent an angel to tell Mary that she was going to have a son and he would be the Savior, the mighty hero who would save people from sin. God said this baby wouldn't have a human father. He would be the Son of God. Listen to what an angel told Mary. "And the angel said to her, 'Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end.'" Whoa. Mary would be the only mother ever who would have a baby without a human father. That seems impossible, but it happened just like God said. God's son Jesus left heaven and came to earth as a human baby. Can you imagine what it must have been like for Mary to be the mother of God's son? Most mothers have to punish their kids for doing bad things, but Mary never had to punish Jesus because he never did anything wrong, ever. But when Jesus grew up, he got punished in a terrible way. Jesus took the punishment for all the sins people have done, like lying, cheating, complaining, and fighting. He let himself be nailed to a cross where he bled and suffered and died to take the punishment for our sin. His mother wished she could save him, but the truth is, he was doing it to save her and everyone else who would believe in him. All people deserve to die and be separated from God because of our sin, but Jesus proved he is the Savior by taking that punishment for us. He died and was separated from God in our place. His mother watched sadly. Can you show me your sad face? She was very sad as his dead body was taken off the cross and buried in a tomb. But then on the third day, God brought him back to life. Imagine how happy his mother must have been to see that the tomb was empty and he was alive again. Today, Jesus is alive and he's the King of Heaven, God's perfect home. But he promised to come back someday and get rid of all the sickness, all the pain, and all the problems in the world forever. He will take everyone who believes in him to live in God's perfect home forever. The Bible says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life." John 3:16. Believing in Jesus means trusting that he really is the Savior God promised, and he really did take the punishment for your sin when he died and came back to life. When you believe in Jesus, he makes you part of God's family, so you will be with him right now and forever. You can believe in Jesus today. He wants to save you and care for you forever. On Mother's Day, we can say thank you to the people who take care of us, like mothers, grandmothers, and foster moms. We can also say thank you to God for using mothers as part of his plan to provide a savior for our sin. Let's talk with God and thank him right now. Dear God, thank you for loving us so, so much. Thank you for giving us mothers and other people to help take care of us. Thank you most of all for sending Jesus to save us from sin. In Jesus' name, amen. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and maybe even share this video with your mom. If you want your own free copy of this Mother's Day Bible lesson craft and card to use in your own home or church, you can get it free today at kidsenjoyingjesus.com. You can also get it free tomorrow or next Friday or any day really, but today is when I would get it if I were you. You can also get a free copy of our Mom Match Bible game that uses animal babies and mothers to review the truths taught in this Mother's Day Bible lesson. I'll put links to all these things in the video description. It's down there, kinda close to the subscribe button. Check it out. Thanks for watching and happy Mother's Day.
So here's a fun challenge I wanted to do with you guys. If you can name 5 kids in the Bible and the names of their mom and post them to Journey Kids on my Facebook page, I will deliver you a special treat this week. Oh, and by the way, you have to do it with your mom. So Mother's Day isn't always a happy holiday for everyone. Some people, maybe you included, feel like Mother's Day is a really sad day. For whatever reason, your mom can't be with you today, and I'm sorry about that. But I truly hope and pray that God has given you another mother to take care of you. A grandma, an aunt, a foster mom, another caregiver, whoever that is. You are so special to have someone that loves you that much. The Bible tells us that God is a father to the fatherless. I like to think that God can also be a mother to the motherless. In the Bible, God tells us what a perfect mother looks like and gives us examples. When Moses led the Israelites out of Egypt and crossed the Red Sea, they were hungry. And so God provided food for them. God was a good provider for them. And I bet that your mom makes food for you and gives you lunch and dinner and snacks and just loves you that way. One other way that our moms love us is making sure that we go to bed on time and get enough rest so that we get good sleep and we're not cranky. Well, Jesus knew that the disciples were really, really tired after feeding the 5,000. So he said, go here and rest. The Bible tells us that God comforts us. Jesus wipes away all of our tears and wants to be there for us. When that hole inside of us is so big and so empty, he just wants to be there to fill it. So I pray that you will reach out to God and that you will just say, God, fill my heart. It's so empty. It hurts so much today. I miss my mom. I wish I had a mom. I wish my mom could be here with me. Now listen. And he truly loves you and cares about you. When your mother can't be with you, I, God, am with you always, and I love you. I hope you have a great day. And celebrate that mother that God has given you in your life, because they love you so much.
Well, that was fun to spend time with you and your moms. Have a great day. Don't forget to love on your mom. Don't forget to ask questions and spend time with her. It's all about her, remember? Maybe go do some extra chores or make her a special gift. Write her a card. It doesn't have to be much. We just love anything from you. Even those dandelions in the backyard, we secretly love those too. So spend some time with your mom. Love her so much and just thank her. She does so much for you. That's what it's all about today. If you have not sent me a video for next week's blast off lesson,
send me some videos.
There's so many things that you can do. All you need to do is say 1, 2, 3, blast off. Shoot a paper airplane, Maybe you've got a toy rocket. Bubbles we had last week. That was pretty cool. Send me some videos. JKIDS@JourneyFamilyChurch.com. Have a great week, guys. I'll see you next week. And next week, we're going to blast off.
From my head to my shoulders, my knees to my toes, I praise the Lord.